Now we'll discuss about the direction of magnetic force on a current carrying wire. As we already discussed that on a current carrying wire, magnetic force is given by I L cross B. So from this expression we can say that the direction of FM vector can be given by right hand thumb rule. By using the concept of cross product, if we rotate our fingers of right hand from L vector to B vector, thumb will give the direction of magnetic force on the current carrying wire. But other than right hand thumb rule, also there are two rules which are quite useful for analyzing the magnetic force on a wire. We can write, other than right hand thumb rule, direction of magnetic force on a current carrying wire can be given by, one is Fleming's left hand rule and the other one is right hand palm rule. Right hand palm rule is similar to what we already discussed about the force experienced by a moving charge in magnetic field. Similar to that we can calculate. Let's discuss both of these rules in realistic situation on the next sheet. So let's first discuss about Fleming's left hand rule. And to understand this Fleming left hand rule, here we can see a situation in which a magnetic induction exists from left to right, which is B vector, in which a wire XY is placed, which is of length L and it carries a current I in upward direction. Now, Fleming's left hand rule states that if we just spread our thumb, index finger and middle finger in mutually perpendicular directions, here you can see in the situation, for our left hand, if we stretch our index finger, middle finger and thumb in mutually perpendicular directions. And in this situation, if we point our index finger along the direction of B vector, here you can see we are pointing. And in this situation, if we point our middle finger along the direction of current, and in this situation current, or basically we can write it positive charge flow direction, because current is in the direction of positive charge flow, then we can say our thumb will give us the direction of magnetic force. And here in this situation you can see that our thumb is pointing in inward direction, so in this situation the magnetic force acting on it will be in inward direction. This is one rule. Another rule we can write, that is the right hand palm rule, which we already studied. In right hand palm rule, you know, we spread our right hand palm in such a way that if our fingers are pointing in the direction of B vector and we keep our thumb in the direction of current, or it is a positive charge flow direction, then in this situation our palm face will give the direction of magnetic force. This is a situation here you can see. Again in this situation the direction of our palm face here will be in downward direction or inward direction to the perpendicular to the plane of the sheet. This is the way how we analyze right hand palm rule and Fleming's left hand rule. Here right hand palm rule is more useful and comfortable in various cases. So I prefer this rule to be used in upcoming applications.